and I'm live. Look at that. Man, I gotta fix my hair before I go on. Hi.
Hi, YouTube.
I figured it was easier to just go live than record a video and then edit the video. You know, for a while now, since I've been using the iPhone, the video defaults to videos that are too big. So you gotta get another app, and then you gotta trim the video down to where it's not as big, just to be able to upload it onto YouTube. Can you leave that shit? But I can go live, and I already got, you know, four viewers immediately. Hi. So I figured it was easier to do it this way than the other way. Just I put it right onto YouTube, and then I go and I edit it and put the tags and work smarter, not harder. Shit. Hi, y'all. Your dear Uncle Birch. I came to, well, first of all, I like to go live and, you know, see people, and they get to comment and ask questions, stuff like that. And, when I've gone live, it's been like usually going to pick my kid up from school, so like 2 p.m. So it's like, it's almost 5, people getting off work. Maybe, you know, have more interaction that way. But the reason for the video, if you know, you saw the title, maybe I did. I just started my long-awaited class, and it longer than it should have waited. Hello, Punky V Eclectic. It shouldn't have taken so long. Sometimes I spend too much time trying to assemble material or get a format. Hello, Heather. When that's not the way I teach. The way I teach, I set my mind on a subject in the occult, and I turn on the video and I start talking, and it works for me. That's my format. Other people got a lot of fancy editing, graphics, shit like that, PowerPoint program. No, it's not the way I do it. This works for me. So I finally just started it, and it's gonna be probably you know, the next week, gonna be more coming out. But I just launched my first class in the Witchcraft Without Wicca series. I hope it's gonna be at least 13 sessions. I'm trying to make it my least expensive class on Gumroad, just so, you know, more people can, you know, partake. The first class, like, I think it's $15, might be 20 for the other classes. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with that, but I'm trying to, you know, keep the cost down, because I understand, especially like a lot of you people out there, a lot of the people that are students in my classes are studying a bunch of stuff, and maybe in 3 or 4 courses, and then you got all your witchcraft supplies, and yeah, I know, it adds up, yeah. So far, I normally tell YouTube about it, and then people start buying the class. I launched it yesterday, and the class is selling. So I barely really even put out an announcement. So I think, I don't know, if you go to gumroad.com/witchschool, that's WITCHSKEWL, and when I edit this, I'll put it in the thing, I guess, the notes. Go over to gumroad.com/witchschool, and you see all the stuff I've got. The course that I used to teach here on YouTube, that takes a year, or used to take a year and a day. I put the entire course up there. Hello, occult fan. I see you all the time, huh? So the course that I used to teach on YouTube, and occult fan took the course, he just said, that I used to teach on YouTube, that took a year and a day. I just, that's old fashioned. People don't do it that way anymore. People want to binge. I started to have people contact me and say they like binge watch me. They put me on like autoplay and just let it roll. And a couple people do that, and they listen on their way to work, you know, like it was a podcast or something like that. I mean, really, that totally works. You just miss all my talking with my hands, you know. It totally works. So That one of the reasons I changed that. Hello, Ken from Hawaii. Aloha. And a cult fan again. I took the course, but still need to do the homework. Yes. The thing is, with the Witchcraft 1 course that's already on there, either if you took the course from me in the old-fashioned way, or if you took it on Gumroad, there's no, you know, you get your homework in before I die. That's basically it. I started teaching that class about probably 5 years ago, and I have people from the first session turning in homework now. It's like I had to go look them up. I didn't even remember their name because I'd never heard from them. I just sent them the lessons, never heard anything from them. Hello, Stephanie. Sent them the lessons, never heard anything from them, and then 5 years later, they start turning in homework. You know, wanting to get initiated into my the Circle A group. But anyway, I'm not here to talk about that. So I've got that. I've got the advanced course. I've got the spiritual warfare. Yes, occult fam. They are trying to get initiated into Circle A, my system. So a bunch of classes. I got a tarot class up there. It'd be a lot. I did a lot of moving. I had to move and then be in a transitional place and then wait for this place to be done, then move to this place. You know, it took a long time to get unpacked, and you know, moved the shop 3 times, way behind on my orders. Starting to catch up. But with my kid just distracted the hell out of me. But I got a lot to teach. There's more coming out in the spiritual warfare. I make excellent candles. Thank you, occult fan. In the spiritual warfare, because I'm teaching a 3-part series at Hexfest this year in New Orleans in magical warfare. From hopefully my soon-to-be upcoming book, The Art of Magical Warfare. But more on that later. But now, I just started this course that's been eating at me for like months. Been trying to do this course, and I had to get a good mic. That was one of the things that held me back. But one of the things that holds me back is trying to be more prepared than I need to be. Let's see. CRN made a tarot deck titled Hex and something. Oh, well, look at the chat logs and you'll see all that. But I talked a bit about this on my channel, Witchcraft Without Wicca. It's been a long time coming. It's been, I've seen it coming for a long time. I've been in the, yes, it's a great beer, Elysian Space Dust. Long time coming, and I've seen it coming a long time because I've been in the professional occult field for at least 20 years, full-time job. Been most of my life a witch, you know, at least, close to 40 years officially since I knew what I was, but at least 20 years professionally. It's my job. Worked at witch stores, then owned a witch store, then saw that it's at least in a small town, wasn't lucrative to keep the brick and mortar open. I apparently operate in a bigger pond, and in Santa Cruz was a very small pond. I make most of my living on the internet, like I'm doing right now with Gumroad and all that. But I've seen it coming in my professional travelings in the witchcraft field. I've seen it change. Wicca was the way. Wicca was the main way in witchcraft for most of my time. I'm sorry, I'm reading the comments. I shouldn't do that while I'm talking. been a long time coming. Wicca in my day represented a freedom from organized religion. A new, old way. revival of the old gods, you know, is it not a bad idea? Not a bad idea, but the way that that idea turned out probably would make the originators of those ideas, if there are originators, roll in their graves. Wicca has turned out to, in a lot of cases, power trips. A lot of power tripping people out there, a lot of people trying to, you know, hold power over somebody else. The Wiccan reed makes no sense in a realistic world. I say have morals, you know? Do good things. Do right. But having a rule to make you right is never gonna work. Like I always say about Christians, you know, if you're only nice to people because you're afraid you're going to burn in hell after you die, then you're not a nice person. You're not a good person. You're a scared person. You've been scared into being, you know, temporarily nice. That's all it is. You should do good things, do right things, do just things. Think of justice in your magic. And your justice may mean something different than other people's justice. And I don't judge people's lives, people's worlds. I give them advice. They can follow it, they can not follow it. They can do what they want to do. But I would hope that people are right about what they're doing out there. And we don't need a Wiccan reed. We don't need a rule. Those of you that don't know, I'm an anarchist. I don't need a cop to tell me what to do. I don't go around hurting people. It's not the right thing to do. Not because a scary man with a gun is going to stop me from doing it. Arrest me if I do it. That's not why I do good things. I would hope the same of anybody that follows my teachings. Just do good things. And sometimes, doing somebody in can be a good thing. Sometimes some people need to be stopped from their evil ways. Even when my parent tradition is pre-Wicca, and like a lot of pre-Wicca traditions, when Wicca became the dominant force, they adopted Wicca into it, made it fit into their mold. They borrowed from Gardnerianism and all over the place, but they had their own tradition, and the form, the ritual form around the tradition ended up being essentially, you know, pretty much Wicca, still with, you know, defense magic and volatile magic still in there, but, you know, still, you know, talking about the Wiccan reed. Hold on a second. See, I ain't posing. Just in case you think I'm posing, this is Sabo. Hi, buddy. Alright, where the fuck was that? Well, not like I really had a big format to follow here. I'm talking about a new class on gumroad.com/witchschool. That's WITCHSKEWL. And Gumroad, like gum on your shoe. Without witchcraft, Wicca wouldn't have a whole lot. But not all witchcraft is Wicca. Wicca was just the dominant force for a while, and it is no longer, and it is fading fast. There are many other magics on the occult landscape these days, and many forms of witchcraft out there. Trader Joe beer. Well, you know, Trader Joe's does have a good double IPA. Now that you mention it, for like six, it's like $5.50 or something like that. Which I, you know, one of these costs more than that. But it's decent when I'm low on cash. Yeah, I picked that shit up. The Boatswain, I think it's called. Boatswain Double IPA. It's in a fucking can, which I hate, but this ain't a beer commercial, all right? Stop making me talk about beer, you people. But, so I've been meaning to do this class for a very long time, and definitely in recent years, it's become a necessity. I find myself with all my notches in my belt, my buckles on my garter, as it were, having to argue with noobs from the BTWs, the British Traditional Witchcrafts, when I see them tell somebody on the interwebs that they are not really Wiccan because they are not initiated in the Gardnerian line or the Gardnerian lineage. I maintain that Gardner never tried to rule Wicca that way. I maintain that Gardner didn't even create a thing called Wicca. All of his books were witchcraft. Wicca was a race of people. In his first book, The New Forest Witches, were the Wicca, W-I-C-A. I don't know where the other C comes from. But anyway, I don't want to give too much. I don't want to give too much of the class away, but it's, you know, that kind of thing. There's lots of reasons. Staunch traditionalists throwing their weight around, acting like authority figures. Yeah. Big turnoff for a lot of people that left organized religions to join Wicca. Well, that was a fuck up, wasn't it? The Wiccan Reeve, silly ways they used the threefold law. We're not supposed to be an organized religion. And most people left organized religions. I already talked about that. But this idea, these moral laws or rules, you know, the threefold law. The threefold law has a lot of meaning to it, and a lot of which I do not subscribe to it, but the way Wiccans tend to talk about it, it's like some punishment reward scheme of the gods. And that was not us. That was not our way. All right, I just entered low power mode. Shit, I didn't even notice that coming. That was not our way. Never was our way. We should have morals, but should be on an individual basis. You have your morals, I have my morals. I'm not gonna judge what's right for you. I'm not gonna judge what's going on in your world. You come to me for consultation, I'll tell you what I think, and you can do what I think or don't do what I think. I'm not your mama, I'm not your papa. And a lot of Wicca became bunch of moralistic judging stuff. And then on top of that, not everyone's witchcraft is a religion. Some people's witchcraft is a spirituality. And there are many forms of it. Wicca was freedom, and now it's regimentation, it's limitation, it's indoctrination, if you will. It's, I don't know, it's gotten kind of stale. So I thought it important, since there are a lot of similar Wiccan elements in my normal Witchcraft 1 course, that I should do a system devoid of that. I'm sure, you know, some stuff will cross over here and there. There are a lot of things that, you know, Gardner borrowed for his Wicca that are indelible parts of witchcraft. And those, you know, those would be kind of unavoidable. But anyway, thanks for joining us there, Ken. Merry meet again. I got to go too because my battery's going to die in just a second. But when you get out and do a live thing, see who pops in. I guess this time of day is a good time to go live and see who pops up. Might do that here and there, but check it out. Check out everything I got out there. 93 there, CDC. My parent tradition was an umbrella It had lots of traditions. There were OTO members in our fold, so it's probably why there's so much ceremonial magic in my parent tradition too. So my witchcraft one has, you know, a lot of ceremonial magic, some Wiccan aspects, and I wanted to do a system away from that, just witchcraft, not Wicca, for those people that have seen the kind of things that I've seen. And I would hope those trying to claim the throne and enforce their authority over Wicca under the BTWs or whoever you are, hello envoy of the dragon, I hope those people can see that. I hope you can see that. It's I understand Wicca doesn't recruit. That's what they always said, but the opposite of recruiting, not a good idea either. There was a lot of freedom in Wicca, and now I see a lot of limitation. And not all forms are that way, but the forms that are not that way would be frowned upon by your average BTW people as not being real Wicca in the line of initiation of Gerald Gardner. So anyway, check out my new class, Witchcraft Without Wicca, and all my classes on gumroad.com. That's gum like gum on your shoe, road.com/witchschool. That's W-I-T-C-H-S-K-E-W-L. W-I-T-C-H-S-K-E-W-L. I think there's, you know what? I should check. I need to set up a streaming option because some people watch on their phones, but I don't know if I set that up yet. They'll be coming out in the next week. There'll be several more classes. I put one in the series up just yesterday, and there's going to be a whole lot more coming up there. And yes, CDC and the Scottish Rite. Yes, my high priest was a Mason, so yeah, he included a lot of Mason stuff in the tradition too. And actually, I kind of argued with that at the time because it was not part of the tradition before. But he did implement some Masonic mysteries in the tradition right in front of me. And I went, huh, wait a minute. You can't tell me to tell my students that that was in the old books. If you add something new, go ahead. You're the high priest. Add something new. But I'm not going to say that that was old school. All right. Really should go. Thank you all for joining me. Bunch of people. Bunch of comments. I might go live from home more often. I usually only go live in the car, and when I go live in the car, I can't see the comments. So yeah, maybe I'll do this more, man. All right, merry meet y'all. I still have old habits, like saying merry meet, merry part, merry meet again, y'all.